everyone, nice to meet you again. This is Fabiana from Wayken Rapid Manufacturing. Today, I'm going to speak a big thing about anodizing aluminum. If you are interested in this topic, welcome to join me. As a super durable post-processing method, anodizing aluminum is not only enhance the performance and appearance of a part, but also better strengthen the adhesion of primers, paint and glues. Currently, there are three tiers of the anodized aluminum. Each of them has its own advantages. Anodized type 1. This is the most basic type. Use chromic acid to produce a thin and ductile anodized layer on the aluminum part. Anodized type 2. Instead of using chromic acid, type 2 utilizes sulfuric acid in order to produce a thicker anodized layer on the part, make it more suitable for coloration. Anodized type 3. Similarly to type 2, this method also uses sulfuric acid, but produce a thicker anodized layer that is also suitable for coloration. It's also commonly known as hard anodizing. With the technology of aluminum anodizing developers very advanced and mature, generally speaking, it is consisting of up to 5 individual steps. Step 1. Pretracking. Rack. If you want anodized aluminum, the part being anodized must be racked and then immersed into a sulfuric acid bath, then cleaning and etching. This is to remove the grease or oils which can interfere with the anodizing process and keep the consistent dimensions as before. Desmarting. After etching, the aluminum part surface will leave some elements like zinc or silicium. If we don't remove these elements but anodize directly, there will leave some spores which will impact both functionality and the cosmetic of the anodized aluminum part. Step 2. Anodic oxide. After pretreatment, we will step into the most important process of anodizing, which is the anodize itself. Submerge into a bath of a sulfuric acid electrolyte solution, which may vary depending on the type of anodizing process chosen. The electrolyte solution has many positive and negative ions and is an electrically conductive solution. The positive ions can attract the negative plates and the negative ions to the positive anode. An electric current courses it in the circuit. The negative ion attracts the aluminum parts, which is the positive anode. The aluminum parts will serve as an anode. At the same time, a cathode is installed within the tank to allow an active passing of electrical current through the system and induce the release of oxygen ions from the electrolytic solution. This process will create aluminum oxide in the substrate, which is what's called a barrier layer, but it is rougher than the aluminum surface. Step 3. Resin. This process is very important. If it doesn't operate correctly, the viscous chemical film may stick and then it will damage the anodizing layer after it's finished. Step 4. Coloring. The anodic coating formed on the surface layer is porous by the structure, which allows the addition of a color into the pot. There are several methods to add color to anodized aluminum. Different colors need different methods. The most popular methods of coloring anodized aluminum is electrolytic coloring. Step 5. Sealing. To close the porous surface created in anodizing and provide a uniform surface, the parts are subjected to a final step that will submerge them into a nickel acetate solution. Sealing ensures long-lasting color and prevents further corrosion for the anodized part. Thank you for watching. Wayken has its own unique advantages in anodized aluminum parts. If you have any metal parts need to be anodized, welcome to contact us.